All right, so we got a new part in the mail today, and this is how it came. This box is hella heavy. I didn't realize how heavy it was gonna be. Oh shit, dude. What is this, dude? Oh, it's a fucking thing, dude. Alright guys, so here's the new part for the G. Before I start, I want to tell you guys how fucking heavy this thing is. Like, I seriously don't know how the FedEx guy walked with it from the street all the way to the front of the house. That should trip me up, because I barely got it from that door right there all the way to right here. Alright guys, so this is going to be G37 differentials 101. The reason why I'm going to tell you guys about differentials is because this can be a good mod for some of you out there who's trying to get a little more power or acceleration out of your G37. Some of you want to cruise, some of you want to race. I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about this mod right here. So anyways, this right here came out of a G37 IPL automatic. Now, there's a difference between the G37 automatic and the manual. So the automatic has a gear ratio of 3.35 or 3.6, and the manual differential has a gear ratio of 3.69, which is a little bit taller than the automatic. Now, the reason why some people want to do this mod and take the 3.69 and put it into their automatic transmission, which is a 3.35, is because they want more acceleration. The reason why you want more acceleration is because it's obviously more funner. But there's advantages and disadvantages to this. So if you give it more acceleration, you lose top end. And when you lose top end, you lose gas mileage on the freeway. But it's fun when you're taking off. Now, if you guys are wondering, the taller you go in gears, the higher your RPM is when you're cruising on the freeway. So let's just say, for example, you're cruising at 80 miles an hour with a 3.69 gear ratio. It would probably be at 5,500 RPM versus the lower gear ratio of an automatic at 3.35, which is cruising at, what, maybe 4,000 RPM. Now, that's the difference. Alright, so I'm going to show you guys a little something. Now, if you want to know the gear ratio of your car, it's pretty easy. All you have to do is open up your door and look at the VIN number sticker, which is right here. Now, if you look at axle, it says RC33, so that 33 means 3.3. Now, some of you out there might have a manual. It'll say RC36, which is 3.6, which is a taller gear ratio. But that's how you check, guys. Look on your door and look on your axle. Another thing you guys should know is that, like, if you see this right here, this drive shaft flange, there's three spots where you can bolt it up to, and it's like a star style kind of flange. Now, when you see this kind of style, that means it's for an automatic. There's two types. So the manual stick shift is basically a circle, and I'm not sure if it has three or four places to bolt on, but those are the differences. Automatic has the star, and the stick shift has a circle, like a plate. The reason why I bought this differential is because this came out of a G37 IPL. It did come out of an automatic, so it has the same gear ratio. Now, I'm happy with my gear ratio on my 7-speed automatic. And after doing research, the 7-speed automatic transmission is basically well balanced. So it's basically like an all-around transmission that you can drive where you have performance and it's a gas saver and everything all around. But the reason why I bought this is because it came off an IPL, G37 IPL 2011. IPLs came with limited slip differentials. So the G37 is gonna be a little more funner. Check that out, guys. It's a limited slip for you. Alright, so the last thing I want to talk about is the mounts. Now, it's up to you if you guys want to change them out, but when you do buy a differential and it's already out, it just makes more sense to change them out. These ones look like they're new, but I bought some aftermarket ones anyway. I just want to tighten up the rear end. If you guys are experiencing any kind of thump or shifting in the back or the rear end, this is the reason why right here. And there's one right here on the cross member or the body or something. I forget what it was. I ended up going with these. These are aftermarket. These are, you know, they're obviously going to be a lot stiffer than the stock ones. So, yeah, check these ones out right here if you guys do differential swap. All right, guys, stay tuned. All right, so we decided to do the differential today. Just want to show you guys something. Taking out the differential is a little bit of a challenge, but this right here is basically what you need to worry about. There's this hole right here. It's where one of the mounts go. This was a bitch to take off. See what I had to do? It was fucking, yeah. I don't want to do that ever again. So we got the old differential right here. Pop it open on them. Show you guys how it looks like. Looks pretty good. So this is a differential right here. I'll show you, can't twist it off. All right, well, about to switch it, so stay tuned, guys. What's up, guys? So we didn't end up finishing the differential. Now I had to use the old plate, the back plate for my old differential, and put it onto the LSD differential. This is the old one right here. It's actually in pretty good condition. No big pieces of metal in the magnet or anything. Oil was still good. So, let me start by telling you guys, this thing was a bitch to take off because, you know, not only you have to take out that mount right there, where that circle is, you have to, like, loosen everything up and kind of fish the whole differential out of its place, and it's hella heavy. So you guys gotta be careful when you're doing this project, because I mean, you don't want it to land on your fingers or anything. Another thing I want to show you guys are my downpipes. I just put these on. These are the Top Speed Pro 1 downpipes. As you can see, I just put that extender on there. It's an L-shaped extender. I got a check engine light within a week, so I bought another extra extender to make it longer. And it got rid of it for another week and it came back on. So, you know, from my experience, like, the performance is there. You'll get like more wheel horsepower, but you can't get rid of the check engine light. Anyways, yeah, so I'll have the differential in by tomorrow and I'll give you guys an update video. Also, I want to let you guys know that the reason why I'm putting this differential on is because I'm setting up the G. Pretty soon it's going to have more horsepower, so yeah, I'm kind of excited to show you guys. So stay tuned, guys. Alright, so we're about to put the bushing on. Comes with this lubricant right here. Just put it on the edges. Kind of like how you do it at home. So that's slippery, you know. And just like that. Just massage it. I'm doing that right now. Alright, so we got the rear bushing in. We had to get a long bolt and two big washers to pull it into place. It was pretty easy. Let me show you guys. See, it's right there. Let's see. Come on, that's into it. There it is. So we got that in. That was the hard part of this job. Now everything is just reverse process. So now I'm gonna put the oil in. So now that it's, I mean, while it's out, I'm just gonna fill up one quart inside the differential, and then when it's on the car, we're just gonna fill it up until it starts leaking through the fill hole. So the big one on the bottom. Especially. You need the grease? Wanna put the grease on? It goes in, dude. I put them on, dude. Do I need to put these right here?
They were on there. Yep.
Brand new bushings.
Right. Why the fuck they design it like that?
So, we got the differential in. Got it mounted. Mounts. Put the rear mount on. Oh shit. Oh, we ran into another problem though. Putting the axles on. And they're both fucking threaded. So we're gonna have to drill one side. So that's smooth. So I could pull it in. Alright, so we just took the differential out. I gotta measure the thickness of the flange. So this is, what does that say?
12.
So it's about 12. This one on the old differential is a little over 9 millimeters. So the problem here is this is threaded. The holes are threaded, and on this one they're not. So the bolt actually just goes through so that it threads onto the axle. So what we're gonna do, so we don't have to take these off, we're gonna fucking drill these so that it just slides right through.
.6, 10.2.
That one should be good.
Yeah. Too much.
Thought we were almost done. Till that fucking axle part. Oh,
it's biting already.
Hold on, hold on.
No.
Go.
You gotta put a fucking thing in here. Well, after I drill this one and jam it. This cheddar bolt.
Do it.
Bam.
Oh hell yeah! Didn't you see that shit? Didn't you see?
See how it's threaded? We don't want that. It's threaded on both sides, so we have to drill it out.
Damn.
12 more to go. Oh no. 11 more to go.
All right. Cool. We're good, guys. We're good. That's what you call precision drilling. Ryobi. Milwaukee and Ryobi. That's all you need. Alright guys, so we just got the differential in. Kind of windy outside the car. Now, the car feels a lot different. It feels, the rear end feels a lot more tight because of the bushings, the white line bushings that I put in. Also, when I take it out of VCD mode, and I just get on the gas, like it really hooks because both wheels are actually putting power down to the ground. And when I do take turns, like, I don't know, I've never driven a car with LSD before, to be honest with you. It's actually pretty fun because you have full control over the car and it just feels like a how a car should be, you know? Like every car should have an LSD. So yeah, that's basically the results, guys. Like I said, I'm setting up the car, it's gonna have more horsepower pretty soon, so you guys stay tuned and yeah, have a nice day, guys.